Hi, how are you? In this video, we'll show you a post about how to use the software serial library. First of all, we have to go to the blog section from the Industrial Shields website to find the right post. In the blog search engine, we can type software serial and see on the results that there are a few posts dealing with software serial. And in particular, we will explain the post on how to use the software serial library. Let's go. First of all, I would like to tell you a little bit about the software serial library, which is a serial communications port. Arduino usually has a serial communication port, usually called serial TTL, that, to simplify, are basically two pins, the RX and TX. The first one allows the Arduino to receive data and the second one to transmit or send data. This communication port starts from the Arduino UART, so it can be used or normally used as hardware serial. But there is also the possibility to make a virtual serial, which in this case is what we call as software serial. For example, using the SPI communication pins, such as MISO, MOSI, or Select, and what we could do in this case is the use of those pins as RX. In fact, we could use another pin as TX, so we could add even three additional software serial ports. Typically, the serial TTL port is used to configure industrial communications ports. In this case, it could run RS232 or RS485. Arduino-based industrial PLCs already incorporate this type of communications, and sometimes there are some Arduino limitations. I mean, some Arduino boards have only one UART communication port available, such as the Arduino Mega or Arduino Uno, or the Arduino Leonardo as well. In fact, Arduino Leonardo is quite different, we will see later. In this case, if you want to use RS232 or RS485, what we do is configure one of them as software serial, and the other one as hardware serial, using the software or hardware, which allows use the use of Modbus, library and hardware serial when you are using the UART pins. What happens in an Arduino board? Let's see an example. If you have an Arduino Uno, you could use one hardware serial, but it is important to know that this UART is also shared by the USB port on this board. So, if you need to send data through the USB port and also through the RXTX of the Arduino, which are the pins 0 and 1, you might have interference and it won't work. You can see another post where we explain how to remove this problem, because the problem caused an auto reset on the Arduino board. It also happens on Arduino Mega. But when you are using an Arduino Leonardo, this issue doesn't happen, because Leonardos have the UART separated between the serial TTL and the USB port. So here you could send data via USB and send data via TTL serial port. It is important to note that the USB port from any Arduino board is recommended to be used only to program the board. If you want to use this port to send data, there will find some problems. So, we do not recommend it at all, because if the speed is quite high or if the data volume is also high, the chip could be deprogrammed after some hours or days. Therefore, in case you want to use serial communications with Arduino board or with industrial devices based on Arduino, as are our PLCs, we strongly recommend the use of serial communication ports instead of the USB. So, in this example, we show you the use of an Arduino-based PLC or an Arduino board. You can also see the code and some options of configurations. Now, I recommend you continue reading the post to see more information about the specific use of the software serial libraries in the Arduino ID. And I also recommend you to subscribe to the channel, where you can see several videos about the use of Arduino on industrial environments and a lot of interesting information. We have more than 200 posts and we are constantly creating new content. Thank you very much. Don't forget to share the video if you think it is interesting. See you later.